Hi. So a few weeks ago, Sony asked me if I would like to test out the new Alpha 9 version 3. Now, of course, who wouldn't? I said yes. So I took the camera with me to France, where I stayed 3 weeks. And after that, I also had the opportunity to get the 300mm 2.8 G Master lens on top of this. So I could test this combo here in Bonn, where I live. Next to Bonn, there is a lake where there are a lot of birds, and also in our garden, because we have a lot of birds here, and at that time also the foxes with the youngsters. So the plan was to go in France first to a lake nearby, which is also known for a lot of birds, and that turned out to be not that easy as I hoped it. And it sometimes is like that. You get something and you have all these photos already in your mind you want to take, because normally it's perfect there, and then you go there and there's nothing. And this nothing really would stress me for 3 weeks in France. And so have a look at the video. It might be funny to see that sometimes you just fail to find something to photograph. At least the things you had in your mind. So this is not a technical test of the camera. If you want technical specifications of the A9 III compared to the Alpha 1, etc., you will find a lot of videos about it. This is a video about the usage of the camera in the field compared to the Alpha 1, which I'm used to, or the A7 R5 also. I hope it will be interesting for you. I hope you will like the photos I took, not the photos I wanted to take, but I think there are still some of them which are quite nice. And let's start with the video. So yesterday it was really nothing to photograph and nothing to film. And as you know, I have the new A9 III with me, and I really wanted to test it with some flying birds. And first of all, I wanted to get the 300mm 2.8 lens with me, but it was not available at that time, and so I have my 200-600 with me, and that might even be more interesting because it's a lens that many of us own. And we will have a look. We are going to La Réserve Ornithologique du Teche. It's near Bordeaux, and it's a really nice reserve with many birds. And if you are there at the right time and the birds come back from the ocean, there are plenty of birds. So fingers crossed, we will have a lot of birds today there.
Hello.
So Natasha comes home, and we will start very soon. Getting a little bit cloudy. That's quite nice because the light was very harsh.
So, perfect.
Thank you. starting our round, and it's a hike of like minimum 2 to 3 hours without stopping over too long.
And it's always a little bit windy here, so really nice.
That's really nice, yeah. Perfect conditions today.
Yeah.
Having a rest, and we need to eat something. It's quite warm without the wind, and yeah, until now not many birds here. They're still out on the sea, I think, and we hope to see them soon, otherwise we won't get any photos. Yeah, but it's always a challenge if you only have some hours time.
It's so, such a nice landscape,
yeah,
here,
yeah. So let's have a brioche maintenant. Now, not maintenant, now. So we're here now for about 6 hours, and to be honest, it's quite a little bit frustrating. I've been here like 5 years ago and made a film about this nature reserve, and it was full of birds. It was unbelievable. It was so wonderful. And this time there's really nothing. And I have no idea what it is, but you see some ducks, but not a lot of more animals. And last time we've been here, we also saw fox, we saw some deer, and of course, lots of birds. But this time, nothing. So, not a big deal to test out the A9 III here. So, a little bit frustrating also for me. I really wanted to show you some really, really nice photos that show the capabilities of this camera. Yeah, so. We still have 1 hour until they close, so fingers crossed, perhaps we will find something. And yeah, if not, that's the way life is, and you can't predict what you will see, especially if you're shooting wildlife. So after the nature reserve, Letesh was not that great this time because the birds were missing. I thought, why not try to photograph some surface? And today the sea is quite high. The waves, they have a nice line, so you can surf them very well. But there are not many tourists at the moment. So fingers crossed, we will get some nice shots. to test out the A9 III with a pre-capture function. It should be very easy to get that moment. Today it's extra hard because I just had a talk with our neighbors here in French, of course, and now switching back to English. Oh. It's a little bit confusing, really, to do that all the time. So apologies if there are too many errors.
I was able to capture some of the surface. It's not ideal at the moment. The light is quite harsh and there's a lot of moisture in the air. So we'll try this afternoon again. But I also was able to capture some little birds here on the beach. I don't know the name in English for them. And it's so easy to capture that decisive moment when they just start with this pre-capture function. It's really something, well, feels like cheating a bit. It's so easy, and I really wish that Sony would bring this feature as a software update for the A1, the flagship model. Wow, just wow, it's amazing. Next day, next try, so today it's very windy and there are some kite surfers out there, but far away, a lot of mist in the air again, and it's really hard to get the images I had in my mind. So this time, not a lot of luck, and the light on top is very harsh. So, of course, I photographed some of the kite surfers, but to be honest, what I wanted to photograph. So, but I got quite a nice feeling for the camera now, and the grip is fantastic. And yeah, later more about the camera.
Yeah, I think you can see that France was not what I really wanted picture-wise. The rest was fantastic, of course, but yeah. That's how life is. But then I came back to Bonn and I thought, okay, I will go to another lake where there are lots of birds and then to the garden. New day, so back in Germany, as you know, and we're going to a little lake now where there's supposed to be a lot of birds. And I know that lake quite well, and I hope it's not the same as in France and there are no birds, because now I still have the A9 III, and also on top of that the 300mm G Master lens f2.8, and wow, what a fantastic lens. I'm really looking forward to get some nice bird shots now. So let's go. So I just arrived, and there are a lot of birds, and so we will see, perhaps we get some in flight. That would be great. So I did put the teleconverter, the 1.4, on. That's the one I own. And to gain a little bit more reach, because it's quite far away. Now it would be very handsome if the A9 III also had like 50 or 60 megapixels, so you could crop in even further for the photos. For video it's not a problem, you can crop in. And but for photos it's quite far away, so I'm waiting for some birds to pass by when they're flying and hope to catch them. But it's really nice here, except for the noise. Otherwise it would be really wild. Great. Good location here. So I hope you liked the video so far, and now it's time for a conclusion. It's not a technical test, as I told you at the beginning of the video, but I have some points, of course, here, which I really, really liked about the Alpha 9. And of course, first of all, it's the autofocus system, which is just amazing. Its tracking capabilities and everything is better than on the Alpha 1. Second, the speed of the camera, 120 frames per second. If you are a photographer who needs this feature, it's of course fantastic to have it. The most used and most loved feature for me on this camera, shooting birds, etc., is really the pre-capture function. And I really wish that Sony would bring this function as a software update for the Alpha 1 if it's technically possible. I don't know that, of course, but this feature makes capturing birds in flight, etc., so easy. You never miss the decisive moment, and it's really hard to go back now to the Alpha 1, which doesn't have this feature. I will miss that a lot. Also, the ergonomics of the camera are much better. The grip is a little bit bigger now, and for my hands, it's really fantastic to hold. And one feature that I really miss on the Alpha 1 is, of course, the display, because now you can flip it also to have a landscape in portrait mode, and you see a lot if you are down on the floor, and that's really great. Of course, they can't deliver this via software update. Talking the cons of the camera, I only have two complaints, very little complaints. It's the dynamic range is a little bit less than on the Alpha 1. It's not by far, but it's a little bit less. And the resolution, of course, because with the Alpha 1, I can crop in quite a lot. And so sometimes I don't even have to use a teleconverter. So I just crop a little bit in, and that's okay. And I wish they would bring the new Alpha 1 in the future with the capabilities of the A9, the back monitor of the A9, and the same resolution as now, like around 60 megapixels. That would be really, really great. So that's my wish. The A9 or the Alpha 1 with the capabilities of the A9 and the resolution of the Alpha 1 and the dynamic range. That's it. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and now I will show you some of the images I took in my garden, and so stay tuned, because I think they're worth watching. See you soon.